The New Testament lesson for today comes from the Gospel of Luke, chapter 24, verses 1 through 11. Give heed now to the word of the Lord. But on the first day of the week, at early dawn, they came to the tomb, taking the spices that they had prepared. They found the stone rolled away from the tomb, but when they went in, they did not find the body. While they were perplexed about this, suddenly two men in dazzling clothes stood beside them. The women were terrified and bowed their faces to the ground. But the men said to them, "Why do you look for the living among the dead? He is not here, but has risen. Remember how he told you while he was still in Galilee, that the Son of Man must be handed over to sinners and be crucified, and on the third day rise again." Then they remembered his words, and returning from the tomb, they told all this to the 11 and to all the rest. Now it was Mary Magdalene, Joanna, Mary the mother of James, and the other women with them who told this to the apostles. But these words seemed to them an idle tale, and they did not believe them. This is the word of the Lord. Thanks be to God.
We have some guests in our worship service this morning. For those of you who are visiting, my name is Dr. Maynard Pittendre. I'm the pastor of Grace Covenant Church, and with me is the pastor of... The way I pronounce it is the Ministry of Hope and Restoration, or Hope and how do you pronounce it in Spanish?
Restauración y Esperanza.
Yes, Restoration and Hope.
You can repeat?
No. And Pastor Amadeo leads the worship service at 12:30, and we've got many of his congregation here today, and you can introduce yourself.
Yeah.
And you can introduce me and pronounce my name correctly.
Yeah. It's hard for me. Tenemos algunos invitados en nuestro culto esta mañana, que son los hermanos de la Iglesia Restauración y Esperanza, our members in Restoration and Hope, o Restauración y Esperanza. Yo soy el pastor de la Iglesia Presbiteriana Grace Covenant Presbyterian Church. Conmigo está el pastor... del ministerio, pastor Minor, Dr. Minor. Sorry.
Now,
it's very hard for me.
For a long time, I called him Armadeo because I'm a Southerner. I put an R in every syllable. But it's Amadeo and Maynard Pittendre.
Pittendre.
Close enough.
Yo soy el pastor Amadeo Torres del Ministerio de Restauración y Esperanza. Nosotros adoramos en la lengua española a las 2:30 todos los domingos y me alegro que esté conmigo esta mañana.
Amadeo and I both had similar experiences recently. My father-in-law died in February, and in March, Amadeo's father-in-law died.
Amadeo y yo tuvimos las mismas experiencias hace poco.
No.
Mi suegro murió en febrero, he said that, y en March, my father-in-law died, o mi suegro murió.
No matter where you come from, there are traditions when people die, and we find comfort in those traditions.
No importa de dónde vengas, hay tradiciones cuando la gente muere. Encontramos consuelo en estas tradiciones.
I come from South Carolina, and in South Carolina, when there is a death in the community, everybody goes to the home of the family, and they bring food, lots and lots of food. And it's tradition that the food be cooked, as always in the South, with butter and with lots of bacon grease. When I was a child, my mother would cook bacon in a skillet, and then she would save the bacon grease like it was a spice. And you would add that to green beans and any other vegetables you might have. Some of you are looking astonished, but we did this really. It made me the man I am today.
Yo vengo de Carolina del Sur, Y en Carolina del Sur, cuando hay una muerte en la comunidad, todos van al hogar de la familia y traen comida, mucha comida. Y un montón de que se hace con mantequilla, mucha mantequilla, y también se hace con grasa de tocino. Cuando yo era un niño y mi madre cocinaba tocino, era para mantener, ella mantenía la grasa del tocino para añadir a los jugos verdes y cosas por el estilo. Y traen pollo frito, pescado, pan de maíz, pasteles y más pasteles.
Amadeo, your father-in-law died recently. Where was he from and what were some of the traditions of that country?
Amadeo, tu suegro murió recientemente. ¿Dónde procedí y cuáles son algunas de las tradiciones de este país? Sí, mi suegro murió y mi suegro nació en el Perú y murió en el Perú. Y algunas de las tradiciones en nuestro país es que la gente llora, otras hacen muchos, se ríen, otros comen bastante también, pero también toman bastante alcohol. Yes, my father-in-law, he's died the past month. So our culture celebrate the funeral. Many people is laugh, many people is crying, and other people is eating, and too much alcohol.
Too much what?
Alcohol.
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 Yeah, I think we do that in the South too. Amadeo, where do your church members come from?
Amadeo, ¿quiénes de tu iglesia han venido el día de hoy?
I bet every country and every town has its own traditions and customs when it comes to funerals.
Mucha gente que viene a los funerales viene también de diferentes costumbres.
In the Holy Land, during the ministry of Jesus, there were customs there as well.
En Tierra Santa, durante el ministerio de Jesús, también había costumbres allí.
The body of the dead were washed by the family and friends. The body was wrapped in a cloth shroud. Spices such as myrrh and others were added to the cloth. And the body had to be buried that night. If the body was not buried that night, then wild animals or insects would come and desecrate and eat the corpse. And that would be a terrible thing for the family.
Los cuerpos de los muertos fueron lavados por familiares o amigos. El cuerpo estaba envuelto en el sudario de tela. Las especies tales como la mirra se agregaron a la tela. El cuerpo tuvo que ser enterrado esa noche. Sí, el cuerpo no fue enterrado inmediatamente. Entonces los animales salvajes podrían venir, tratar de comer el cadáver. Y eso sería algo terrible para la familia.
Jesus died on a cross on a Friday. There was no time for the family to take care of the body properly. They had no time to wash and anoint the body with spices, but he had to be buried. So without properly cleaning and preparing the body, they just wrapped up the body and very quickly buried it in a borrowed grave.
Jesús murió en una cruz el viernes y no hubo tiempo para la familia pudiera tomar cuidado apropiado para su cuerpo. No tenían tiempo para lavarlo y ungirlo su cuerpo con las especies mencionadas, pero tenía que ser enterrado, así que sin limpiar y preparar adecuadamente su cuerpo, simplemente lo envolvieron su cuerpo y lo enterraron en una tumba prestada.
The reason there was no time to properly prepare the body of Jesus for burial was that he died on the Sabbath, or rather the Sabbath was about to begin when he died, and no work could be done on the Sabbath.
La razón por la que no hubo tiempo para preparar adecuadamente el cuerpo de Jesús para su entierro fue que después de su muerte el sábado estaba a punto de comenzar y no se podía hacer ningún trabajo porque era el día sábado.
So Friday night and all day Saturday, Jesus was in the grave. On Sunday, the third day, some women came to the grave to finish the work of bathing and wrapping the corpse of Jesus to prepare him for his eternal resting place.
Así que el viernes por la noche y todo el día sábado, Jesús estaba en su tumba. El domingo, el tercer día, algunas mujeres fueron a la tumba para terminar el trabajo de bañarlo y envolverlo, el cadáver de Jesús, para estar preparados, o que estuviera preparado para su eterno lugar donde él iba a descansar.
Now what they found was that the tomb had already been opened.
Lo que encontraron fue la tumba que estaba abierta ya y vacía.
The women found the stone had rolled away from the tomb, but when they entered, they did not find the body of Jesus. And while they were wondering about this, suddenly two men in clothing that gleamed like lightning stood beside them.
Las mujeres encontraron la piedra rodada lejos de la tumba, pero cuando entraron no encontraron el cuerpo del Señor Jesús. Mientras se preguntaban acerca de esto, de repente dos hombres con ropas que brillaban, eran ángeles, como un rayo estaban al lado de ellos.
14. Now these men said to the women, "Why do you look for the living among the dead? He is not here, he is risen. Remember how he told you while he was still with you in Galilee. The Son of Man must be delivered over into the hands of sinners, be crucified, and on the third day be raised again."
Estos hombres dijeron a las mujeres, "¿Por qué buscan a los vivos entre los muertos? Él no está aquí más. Se ha levantado. Acuérdate de cómo te dijo que estaba aún conmigo en Galilea. El Hijo del Hombre debe ser entregado a manos de los pecadores, ser crucificado y al tercer día resucitar."
The women went and told the disciples. And Peter went to the tomb and saw the empty grave and the burial cloths lying by themselves. And in the Gospel of Luke, it says, he went away wondering to himself what had happened.
Las mujeres fueron y le dijeron a los discípulos, y Pedro fue al sepulcro, vio la tumba vacía y los lienzos de sepultura que estaban solos. Y en el Evangelio de Lucas dice, se fue preguntándose qué había pasado.
Peter was confused.
Pedro estaba muy confundido.
Everyone was confused.
Todo el mundo estaba confundido.
People were confused because there is not a single country on this planet where it is the custom and tradition for people who are dead and buried to rise up and walk out of the cemetery.
La gente estaba confundida porque no hay un solo país en el mundo donde las personas que están muertas resucitan a los tres días y después salen del cementerio.
They don't do that in your country in Peru, do they, Amadeo?
No hacen en Perú esto, ¿verdad, Amadeo?
They don't do that in Venezuela or Puerto Rico or in South Carolina, and certainly not in Florida.
Tampoco lo hacen en Venezuela o Puerto Rico o en Carolina del Sur, y ciertamente tampoco en Florida.
When you're dead and buried, you're supposed to stay dead and buried.
Cuando tú estás muerto, se supone que estás enterrado para siempre, muerto y enterrado.
Amadeo, what would you do if you were walking in the cemetery at the break of dawn and suddenly someone got up out of a grave and started walking around?
I started running.
Me too. Well, if that happened to us today, it would be scary and frightening. It was scary to the women when they heard Jesus had risen from the dead, but we know that this really is good news indeed.
Si esto nos pasara hoy, sería espantoso y aterrador. Y fue espantoso para las mujeres cuando oyeron que Jesús había resucitado de entre los muertos. Pero sabemos que es una buena noticia para todos nosotros.
We celebrate Resurrection Sunday, Easter Sunday, because we rejoice that Christ came back to life, that he is still alive today, and that he died and rose again for us.
Amén. Celebramos el Domingo de Resurrección, el Domingo de Pascua, porque nos regocijamos que Cristo Jesús volvió a la vida, de que todavía está vivo hoy y que murió y resucitó por todos nosotros.
Easter means that Jesus died for our sins.
Pascua significa que Jesús murió por todos nuestros pecados.
Paul said in the New Testament letter to the Romans, "While we were yet sinners, Christ died for us."
El apóstol Pablo dice en el Nuevo Testamento, cuando escribe a la iglesia de Roma, "Mientras éramos pecadores, Cristo murió por nosotros."
We did not have to become perfect people before we could be saved.
No teníamos que llegar a ser personas perfectas antes de que pudiéramos salvarnos.
Pastor Amadeo, Jesus died for you and for your salvation.
Pastor Miner, Jesus died for you and for your salvation. Pastor Amadeo, Jesús murió por ti y por tu salvación.
Jesus died and rose again for the people who speak different languages. Those who come from South Carolina, Florida, Venezuela, Puerto Rico, Russia, Africa, Australia, no matter where you come from, no matter what your language.
Cristo murió y resucitó por las personas que hablan diferentes idiomas, que viene de Carolina del Sur, Florida, Venezuela, Puerto Rico, Rusia, África, Australia, sin importar de dónde provengamos y sin importar nuestro idioma.
Now this is important. Jesus died for everyone. He died for people who are different from us, he died for people who are like us. He died for our friends, he died for our enemies.
Ahora esto es importante porque Jesús murió por todos. Murió por personas que son de diferentes a nosotros. Murió por las personas que no son como nosotros. Murió por nuestros amigos. Murió por nuestros enemigos.
Jesus died for the thief on the cross.
Jesús murió por el ladrón en la cruz.
Jesus died for the thief who breaks into our homes and takes our stuff.
Jesús murió por el ladrón que rompe la puerta de tu casa, entra y te roba.
Jesus died for the Roman soldier who nailed nails into the hands of Jesus on the cross.
Jesús murió por los romanos que clavaron a Jesús en sus manos y sus pies.
Jesus died for the person who hurts us.
Jesús murió también por la persona que nos lastima o te lastima.
Jesus died for the young man who has joined ISIS and is planning to kill innocent people.
Jesús murió también por el joven que se ha unido a ISIS y planea matar a personas inocentes.
If I had been the only one in all of history to accept Jesus as Savior, he would have died for me.
Si yo hubiera sido el único en toda la tierra, en toda la historia, en aceptar a Cristo como Salvador, él habría muerto por mí.
But he died for everyone.
Pero él también murió por todos nosotros.
What this means is that we should not only come in here and celebrate the death and resurrection of Christ, we must also go outside this church building and share the good news with others.
Lo que significa es que no solo debemos venir aquí a la iglesia y celebrar la muerte y resurrección de Cristo. También debemos salir por las calles de esta iglesia y compartir esta buena noticia con los demás.
We should invite our friends to come and join the fellowship of Christians and accept him as Lord and Savior.
Cada domingo debemos invitar a nuestros amigos y unirnos a nuestra comunidad cristiana y aceptar a Cristo como nuestro Salvador.
We should also invite the stranger.
También debemos invitar a los extraños.
We should also invite
a nuestros enemigos.
The enemy.
A nuestros enemigos.
Well, I'm 42. And you must invite other people to come to believe in Christ, to accept Christ, and to live as disciples of Christ.
Y usted debe invitar a otras personas a llegar a creer en Cristo, aceptar a Cristo, y vivir como discípulos de Cristo.
Yes, invite others to join us in the Christian life.
Sí, inviten a otros a unirse a nosotros en esta vida cristiana.
In Luke's gospel, when the women learned about the resurrection, they told others.
En el Evangelio de Lucas, cuando las mujeres aprendieron acerca de la resurrección, se lo contaron a otros.
And we need to be like those women, go out of here and tell others about the resurrection.
Tenemos que seguir el ejemplo de estas mujeres, salir de aquí, contarles a otros acerca de esta resurrección.
Amen.
Amen.
Amen. Yeah, you can sit with your family, yes.